In this lecture, we are going to look at the psychosexual disorders. And psychosexual disorder underneath has two types of disorders. And major one of those are paraphilic disorder and gender dysmorphic disorder. सबसे पहले जो मैं बात करूंगी वो paraphilic disorder की करूंगी. This is a group of disorder which is characterized by recurrent sexual attraction to an unusual object or sexual activities lasting at least for the last 6 months. Now, you know, there is a very normal way of attracting somebody towards the opposite sex, but these people are seeking sexual gratification through unusual ways, which we will discuss in this chapter. DSM differentiate between paraphilias based on source of sexual satisfaction. So the what kind of source they are using to get gratification would actually define the type of disorder. Now, talking about types of disorder, as I said, that this is basically the source of providing satisfaction to the person who has that disorder. First one is voyeuristic disorder. Second one is exhibitionistic disorder. And then frauderistic disorder, sexual masochism, sexual sadism, pedophilic disorder, fetishist disorder, and transvestic disorder. All these disorders have a distinctively different source of gratification. So, जैसे voyeuristic है तो उसमें दूसरों को देखते हुए, exhibitionistic है तो exhibitionistic way में. So, we will look into the details कि किस तरह ये disorders जो हैं इनमें source of gratification of sexual gratification क्या है. There are some common diagnostic criteria for these disorders. जिसका मतलब है कि ये जो मैं common criteria की बात कर रही हूँ ये सब disorder के ऊपर applicable है, except for the source of gratification. So, A, over a period of at least 6 months, recurrent and intense sexual arousal from whatever source we will talk about, depending on the type of the disorder, in the process of disrobing, during the process when the person is undressing or changing clothes or engaging in sexual activity. So, the person is having this kind of a gratification during this phase, and it's manifested either by fantasies, urges or behavior. जिस बंदे को ये disorder है वो या तो fantasies में के अपनी fantasies ख्वाबों में या सोचों में उसके ये problem issues आएंगे, urges होंगी कि he just acts upon what he kind of behavior he is manifesting or the urges he has to according to the source. For example, pedophilic disorder के अंदर हमने देखा कि the people seek gratification by engaging sexually with children. और आपके न्यूज़पेपर्स और आपका मीडिया और आपके एवरीडे लाइफ में आप यू लुक के इट्स बिकमिंग वेरी कॉमन एंड देन इज और द बिहेवियर्स द पर्सन मे एक्चुअली एक्ट इन दोज काइंड ऑफ बिहेवियर्स. क्राइटेरिया बी विच इज आल्सो कॉमन फॉर ऑल दीज डिसऑर्डर्स इज दैट इंडिविजुअल हैज एक्टेड ऑन दीज सेक्सुअल अर्जेस विद अ नॉन कंसेंटिंग पर्सन. नाउ नॉन कंसेंटिंग पर्सन मीन द पर्सन with whom he or she is trying to engage in or fantasize about or you know acting about or having urges is not actually consenting or in actual behavior. For example, children in pedophilic cases are not actually consenting to engage in that kind of activity. But so the another important feature is that the individual with whom or for whom they have that behavior towards is not agreeing on that, and this act has or fantasies are unwillingly about a person who don't even know, most probably in certain cases if the case is towards fantasies. And the sexual urges or fantasies cause clinically significant distress or impairment in all important areas of functioning of an individual. So it has to be to the intensity that the individual's everyday functioning, be it social, emotional, psychological, occupational, gets affected just like any other disorders. So we have seen so far we have the major or salient features of paraphilic disorders and then common types of paraphilic disorder and the common diagnostic criteria of these disorders. And in the next section we will look into the detail of all these disorders.